receiver in motion left. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Going up top for Kupp. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
26. Hey, 88 from the 50. Watch it, Smith, the man in motion left.
To throw once more on second and 10. Rodgers flush to his right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary. All of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage,
he
found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
And to the 49-yard line, but no further. And obviously, he is well short of the first.
Over. Run. Back north.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. They'll let this go for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Two touchdown passes now here in this first quarter for Aaron Rodgers. And the Lions' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point try good by Gano. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario 19, they had last 19, time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. 19, they took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were in the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
Off the play fake. Elway. That's going to be caught by Moss. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Cowboy
21 yards. That's good.
Play action. Elway. Quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that in just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. From the red zone now, Elway on first down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line. Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession as they've got it second and 7. Connect on the extra point, and we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. On ready to kick off the next drive. But right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Well, it hasn't been a banner first half with the defense trying to cover him today, but they'll take that one right there, helping force that incompletion.
So line of scrimmage still at 39 on second and 10.
50, and you want.
They'll give to Falk up the middle. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Throwing now is Rodgers. And he'll look downfield for Waller. This is caught inside the 15. And they got this down to about the 12-yard line. On first down, Rodgers. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, he left no doubt about that one, because even though he hasn't left the pocket, he's got a receiver in the area, so it's not grounding, even though there is no way that ball was going to be caught.
Complete pass here now is second and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Aaron Rodgers, a 12-yard touchdown run as his guys have now moved out in front. Gano the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Taken at the 15, a short kick.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger, a really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Put some guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. On first, they'll throw it away. Out to the flat here for Johnson. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
19, Tiger.
That's another safe.
On first and 10, Elway. And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And the tight end goes in motion left. Play action. It's Elway. Quick hitter here. It's complete. Just a gain of a couple there. And that's going to lead to a third and 12.
It's a gain of two. Brings up third and 12.
And they'll send the tight end in motion.
Trap 60.
On third down, Elway. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. Able to find Walter. That's complete. And he is going to have the Saints first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
He was brought down by Rod Woodson. A 3-yard pickup brings up second and seven at the Lions 19-yard line.
19 tight.
Here's Elway to throw. And he's got it. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Randy Moss, as the first half is winding down. And the Saints have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Tucker with the extra point. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
150. Back one.
Rodgers now on first down. And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. Six-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
88.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
To throw again on second down. Rodgers, it's complete. He finds Falk here. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Throwing is Rodgers. That'll be caught over the middle by Moss. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two.
First down, Lions.
Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. Plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three?
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
They'll send Moss in motion right. Second and 10, Elway again. Got a man, it's Darren Waller. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards the pickup there.
60 Bobcats.
Now Elway on first down. Delivering another one here to Darren Waller. He's got it again. The 30. 10. Touchdown, New Orleans. touchdown. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just letting you know our heads just keep which side has it, which side's going to score, how they're going to go out doing it. A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Just shy of the 20.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here. Hey, take 26. Hey, 88.
Rodgers now on first down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Jason Taylor just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers, throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. Touchdown! Darren Waller, 30 yards. And the Lions have retaken a third quarter lead. Extra point try good by Gano. And that gives him a three-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. A fairly short kick from the 14. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They had gotten the lead with the opening drive touchdown in the third quarter. Now they relinquished that lead. That could be in for an interesting second half.
It certainly appears that way, doesn't it? Almost turning into one of those pendulum games, right? Where it swings back and forth, and who's going to make the play that changes that, that maybe it puts it on one side and keeps it there.
Elway to throw on second. He's got a man complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10.
That's good. For 17. Hey, Buffalo 18. 18,
go. Elway will throw. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Oh, I saw this one with defensive eyes because even as he escaped the pocket and bought time, the coverage stayed tight. Nothing broke down. Throwing it away, that was his only option.
Elway now off of play action. Uses the stiff arm. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down.
Makes it third and four.
From the shotgun, Elway. He'll drop this down to Johnson underneath. And he is going to have a Saints first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6. They fake the give. Now Elway. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Second touchdown of the night. And the Saints have moved out in front here in the final minute of the third quarter. Tucker with the extra point, and that will make this a four-point game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. A fairly short kick from the 14. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
defense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sidelines, partner, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
Now they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. It's a gain of 14 and a first down for Detroit.
Well, they've certainly been successful throwing it around in this game, and that's allowed them to move the ball on offense. But I've got to tell you, to watch them run the football and successfully, I'm not taking sides, but to see the ball in a running back's hands, oh, that's football for me.
They'll go right back to the ground with Falk. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play, second down. We have played three quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Second and seven, operating from the 34.
Inside. Gun. Take 30. Down 326.
Here's Rodgers, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right, the overall game sheet. But you and I know that they keep count on pressures, hits on quarterbacks, all those things, hoping to increase that throughout the game. And here we are in the fourth quarter, and they got a big one.
Yeah, it's such a close game, a very big one.
Take 26. Yeah, this. Jump out.
The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
Go to 50. Hey, you block over here. Plant. Hey, take 26.
Now Rodgers got to have this one. This is Smith with a grab. And they move this all the way down to the nine.
Over, the only way to get the lead here,
of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for, first and goal. Now a give inside for Falk. And only about a yard there as he takes it from the nine to the eight.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
Here's second and goal. Hey, operating from the 8-yard line.
On the 50. Back one.
Rodgers now to throw. Oh, looking for water, but this is intercepted. And the Saints are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line. So that a definite deflator there on the interception.
Yeah, you work your way down the field thinking you're in position for a go-ahead score. But all it takes is one errant throw, and this one winds up a turnover.
The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage.
Here we go.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. It's Johnson. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. A Saints first down there on a gain of 11.
That's good for a Saints.
First and 60 Eagle, 60 Eagle. Dragon 60. 60 Maverick, 60 Maverick. 79 Bronco. Ready?
From the gun, a run for Johnson. That's a gain of four here in the fourth quarter with them leading by four on the scoreboard.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine.
Check smash, check smash.
Now they'll throw it with Elway. He'll find his tight end. That's Waller. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. To throw is Elway. Johnson's got it complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and it's second down. They go back to the ground with Johnson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. In motion, the tight end. Now it's Elway. Here's Johnson with a reception. Well, he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Let's go.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. They'll hand it off now, Johnson. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
60 Bison.
Here's Elway. And this one complete to Smith. It's a gain of 14. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Clock down to zero, and this is not the way to start a drive.
Let's go now. Cougar 19, Cup 19, Cup 19.
Now Johnson, and this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
18, Rattler, 18, go streak.
On second down, Elway. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Go!
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Play action, Elway. Flushed out right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
70 Lions. Dragon 60. 60 Maverick. 60 Maverick. Hurt.
On second down, Elway. And Steve Smith hauls it in. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 39. Elway to throw again. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. In motion comes the tight end left. Now it's Elway. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. On third down, Elway. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Now Justin Tucker's out to try the field goal. From the right hash, this from 53. Tucker's kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one-possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10.
Hawk 70, Hawk 70, 19 tight, 19, 18, Pioneer.
They get it off at 1, Elway. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down. An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Darren Waller, and getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Opening carry of the game for Cordarrelle Patterson, and just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. To his tight end Waller, and that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 36. Now Elway on 1st down, got a man, it's Darren Waller, and all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. Zone now. They'll look to throw. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
You know what I like about that play? He didn't try to do too much on 1st down. He took what the defense gave him, put together a solid gain to bring up 2nd and manageable. Now they have a couple of plays to pick up just a few yards and a new set of downs.
After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. Second down and 3, ball on the 7. Point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Last time out, you remember, their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points. For from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well.
Play action. It's Elway. Got a man. It's Randy Moss complete. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake. Elway. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
19 tight. Go streak.
The center receiver in motion to the right. Elway to throw on second. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground.
Well, this is a half where not just the coverage, but the entire defense is setting the tone in this game.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And they'll send the slot in motion left. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Here we go with Johnson. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration.
Okay, you and I are sitting up here getting ready to analyze whether they should go for it or not. Did you see the quarterback just point to the sideline and say, everybody back, I've got this call.
Well, you knew this side of the field, they're in plus territory, fourth and one. He wasn't coming off the field.
No, he wasn't coming off the field, and he wasn't letting the offense go with him at all. He said, we're staying out here, and we're picking this one up. That's some leadership right there.
This is Smith with a grab. And he'll be taken down with a first down as they get about 14 out of that one, and we go to the two-minute warning. Elway. And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
60 Bison. Dragon 60. Hurt.
Now Elway to throw. And he's got it. Zone for the Seahawk touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks have got it back to within a score. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes it a 14-10 ball game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
Here we go.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Throwing now, Elway on first down. He's got Smith here, and he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
34 yards the gain that time, another first down.
19 right. Go.
To throw is Elway. Oh, and this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it, and it's second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 29. Throwing again, it's Elway. Got a man, it's Patterson complete. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts
They get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. There's Elway to throw. Able to find Waller. That's complete. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Let's go.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Is caught for a Falcon touchdown. A great play there as the first half is winding down. And the Falcons will extend their lead here just before halftime. Tucker with the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
And that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. Complete, 7 seconds remaining. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your good chunks of yards on first and second down.
So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. A fairly short kick from the 14. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. This offense set to begin the third quarter, and Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going. So they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
On first down, Elway. Now into a sea of defenders, and intercepted. Picked off by the 8-time Pro Bowler, Steve Atwater. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Could you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
So the completion good for 7 there. And that's going to bring up second down. Now it's Elway. And Waller taking it in guys will go for two here.
Shut up! 19 light! Ring alert! Ring alert! Set! Temple! Set! Let's go!
They'll look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage, put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head, because they're going to run out of space because in the back of the end zone, never let a guy catch one in front of you.
Ready up.
About
Logan
set
19.
To begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
19,
and we'll
drive.
See if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal is not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit, because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
A nice pickup there, 18 yards, first down Falcons.
Viking 18, 70 Lions.
Elway, and it's complete, right back in the hands of Smith. So just 3 yards on the completion there, and it's second down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is, because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 22 yards there, a first down.
Warriors 17. Buffalo 18. 18 runners. 18 runners.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one, they were just unable to complete the pass.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
70 Rangers, 70 Rangers. Go!
Elway to throw again. And give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice game.
Let's go.
Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's third and inches.
Dragon 60. 60 Maverick. 60 Maverick.
From the gun, it's Elway. And this one complete to Smith. And he is going to have a Falcons first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches. First and 10, Elway. That really sets him back. A loss of 6.
Come on.
Second and 16.
60 Bison, 60 Bison.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter. They'll bring a receiver in motion left.
Trap 60, trap 60. Hustle, hustle.
Now it's Elway. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
On third down, Elway. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Night Train Lane. And the Seahawks are right back in this football game.
Three, three.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
And that's frustrating for a defense, because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play 4 yards on first down. That's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
Third and two. Now Elway. And he's got his man on the out route. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks. Down carry here for Johnson, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
Now that was an excellent run, and when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block, but the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. And now it's third down and inches. They'll send the tight end in motion left. Elway now looking to throw on third. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons 42. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive.
Viking 18, Warriors 17.
They'll give up the middle to Johnson. And he's going to be down at the 35, gain of 7.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Buffalo 18.
Elway to throw. Dancing to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away. How about the call to come with the blitz there in this situation?
And some of those calls happen just because of what they do on offense. So when they send out a number of people in the pattern, sometimes they just make a change on defense, say, okay, we'll come after you instead. And that's exactly what they did.
Here's Elway. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by the great one, Darrell Revis. And the Falcons are going to take possession of the football. When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.